In this video, we look at another series parallel problem where we're solving for voltages and currents. So here's our original circuit over at the left here. And then what I show as we go left to right is the reduction of resistors, okay, each step. So to go from our original circuit to this one, the two 10 ohms that are in parallel were reduced into the single 5 ohm resistor. Also, the current that we're after is the current that's through this 10 ohm resistor. And then to go from this diagram to this diagram, the 1 and 5 in series were combined into the 6. And then for this one, furthest to the right, this diagram, this has the 3 and 6 in parallel reduced into a single 2 ohm resistor, right? Product over sum, 18 divided by 9. So what I chose to do in this problem to solve for I was to use voltage divider equation, that I'm going to find the voltage across this 10 ohm and then use Ohm's law to get what the current is. So to use voltage divider equation, you have to have a series circuit. So once I reduce the circuit down to this, I can apply voltage divider to this diagram. And since I want this current that's over on the right side of the original circuit, it's quickest to solve for this voltage across this 2 ohm resistor, because that 2 ohm resistor represents resistors that are over on the side of the circuit where the 10 ohm that I want the current for is at. Okay, because this 3 ohm here, that's the same 3 ohm as right here in this original diagram. So using voltage divider to find the voltage across the 2 ohm in this diagram, it's just going to be the voltage across the 2 ohm is 90 volts. That's the source voltage. That's the voltage across the series combination of the 3 and the 2. The 2 is going to go in the numerator, 5 in the denominator, and that's 36 volts. Okay, so you see there's 36 volts across this 2 ohm resistor. Well, that 2 ohm resistor in this diagram represents the 3 and 6 in parallel. So you see there's also 36 volts across this 3 and 6 in parallel. Likewise, in this diagram, there's 36 volts there's 36 volts across this 3 ohm, and also across this 1 and 5 in series, there's 36 volts, right? Because see, that 1 and 5 in series is represented by the 6 ohm in this resistor. And then going back to our original diagram, see, there's 36 volts across this 3, and also there's 36 volts across this side of the circuit. There's 36 volts across this one in series with these two 10s in parallel, because after all, that's where this 5 came from. That came from reducing the two 10s in parallel. So you see, that's why, even though it may seem tedious, that's why it's a good idea to write the circuits as you do the reduction. As you reduce the resistors, you rewrite the circuit, because it's going to help us solve for voltages and currents using voltage divider in this case, but you could also solve this problem using current divider. So now that I know that there's 36 volts, if we look in this diagram, now that I know that there's 36 volts across this 1 and 5 in series, and knowing that this 5 came from reducing these two 10s in parallel, and you see it's the current through one of these 10s that I want the current for, well, now I'm going to apply voltage divider to this diagram, to this 1 ohm and 5 ohm in series, and I know that there's 36 volts across that series combination of the 1 and 5. So using voltage divider, if I find the voltage across this 5 ohm in this diagram, that is the voltage across these two 10s in parallel. So you see, that's going to give me the voltage across the 10, And then once I have the voltage across the 10, I just divide by its resistance, and that's the current. So you see, in these types of problems, it's almost like you have to know where you're going in order to get there. Otherwise, you just end up spinning your wheels. So you got to kind of think ahead, you know, what I need to get to where I want to be. Okay, so using voltage divider, the voltage across the 5 is the 36 volts that's across the series combination of the 1 and 5 times 5 over 6. Right, because you always put the voltage, or excuse me, you always put the resistance of the resistor you want the voltage for in the numerator of the voltage divider ratio, and then the denominator is just the sum of the series resistors. So this comes out to 30 volts. 36 times 5, 6 is 30 volts. So you see, that's a V. See, there's 30 volts. Across that 5 ohm resistor, which means that there's 30 volts across these two 10s in parallel. And now the current for that 10 ohm resistor is just going to be the 30 volts divided by 10 ohms. Okay, so 3 amps, that's our answer. Okay, now I would recommend that on your own you start this problem again and see if you can solve for the current through the 10 using current divider equation. Okay, you should get the same answer, of course, because you're going to start off with the same circuit, but that's just some added practice that you can do on your own. Now, one other thing I want to show you here before we end it is this is a problem solution to another series parallel circuit where we're solving for currents and voltages. And in this one, I use current divider to find the currents, and well, it also looks like I use voltage divider in some parts of the circuit, but I started off finding the current for the voltage source, then seeing how the current splits up, and then I think I went back and just also made sure I got the same answers using voltage divider. But I show this because this is another problem you can use to help you practice and do the homework problems that are assigned. So just take this circuit on your own and see if you can find the currents and voltages for these resistors, and you can refer to this solution on PolyLearn. I'm gonna post this on PolyLearn, so you know, go through it yourself, and then you can access this and check your answers against mine.